Hello friends, welcome. In this video, I'll be discussing with you organization of guidance program. Guidance program are generally organized in educational institutions. And what is the purpose and the objective of these programs? The focus or the central point or the focal point of this program is the students. The students are made categorically aware about the various opportunities, and these programs must be regularly organized in educational institutions. Hence, they are termed as the integral part of these institutions, where students can be acquainted with the different types of opportunities available to them. Organization process is participatory activity designed to unlock the potential of students that contain various services. Participatory means the participation has to be from the all stakeholders who are connected with the students. They may be the teachers, they may be the parents, or the senior students, or the students who have been recently enrolled in the educational institutions. Everyone must participate, and they must understand the nitty-gritty of these programs. Name itself suggests it's a kind of guidance, that the word has come from the guide. Means these programs act as a guide for the students for the opportunities which are available in the market. So they are made compulsory and integral part of their curriculum. And they are regularly organized across the board. Due to the present pandemic situation, these programs are still organized but in the virtual platform. So what are the objectives of this guidance program? Let us discuss one by one. To create awareness regarding tests, entrances, interviews, group discussions, skills, etc. among students. We'll focus on the each phrase of the sentence. Regarding tests, test means your vocational test, professional test, and entrance test. Interviews. The students has to face various types of interviews before joining an institution. Group discussions. And what are the new skills which are required in the market? Guidance programs provide all these things to the students. The second objective is to offer support in collaboration with institutional human resources. So what is institutional human resources? Means where you are studying, where the students are enrolled, that human resources are pooled from that institution, and their skills, their expertise are being explain to the students, so that during or after this guidance program, students can take a professional help from them, and they all collaborate with the external agencies and helps in organizing these types of programs to provide specific guidance at micro and macro levels. So there are the two levels in pedagogy. The classrooms are the smallest unit of an education institution. So they are termed as a micro. Whereas the institution as a whole is regarded as macro. Then what is meso? Meso is the process of imparting the education. Here, during these programs, the specific guidance is offered to the student. Specific means if a student belongs to an engineering category or some art and humanities, or some textile industry, or somewhere, they are being offered as the specific guidance, means what are the opportunities and skilling facilities available for the particular courses. So that is the specific guidance. To update parents and teachers regarding latest development in the market and industry, because industry and market is so highly dynamic and volatile, at every moment it changes. Market demands are transitory. Every time they demand something new, and for that the students must be skilled as per the demands of the market and industry. So the guidance program are organized to offer what are the opportunities currently available and what are the future opportunities they may arise in the market. The student must be aware about that, and they must prepare accordingly to meet these skills and opportunities. Then to assist students in overcoming various types of fears and phobia concerning various exams. Most of the students fear for applying for the higher level examination. When I interact with the students, Most of the students of my college ask, sir, can we crack the UPSC exam? See, they feel reluctant to fill up the form itself, and they think that they cannot do it. So during the guidance programs, the experts explain this phenomena that everyone can participate and can crack any exam, depending upon the type of preparation and type of interest individual is showing. Your IQ intelligence had some role in that. Apart from that, your hard labor, your smart work, and your sustainability is a very important one. So I generally focus on this point. So we must not fear, we must not have a phobia regarding any type of exam. At any level, if you find there is a vacancy or there is a requirement, try for that. So never have a phobia or fear of any test. And this is a major objective of the guidance program. To help students in identifying their strengths and weaknesses. At various levels, students, they know they're almost what are their strengths. But when it comes to the weaknesses, they lack in this domain. So the focus of this guidance program is to make the students aware what are their strengths and what are their weaknesses. On the weakness front, and you can find the alternative solutions for that. Then to help them in acquiring skills needed for dealing with the prospective challenges. Because life at every step offers you challenges. And these challenges are unique for everyone. Especially students. When students are in the universities or the colleges, in this environment, they feel safe and they are being fed by their parents. All information is fed from their respective teachers. But when they go in the market or industry or in the real world, the moment they put their stuff there, they feel the heat of the competition. For that, they need different type of skills. For skilling, these programs are organized. Then, what are the characteristics of this guidance program? More or less, characteristics and objectives, they sometimes seem to be overlap. But difference between these two. The guidance for each and everyone by experts and professionals. This is the major characteristics. Every student, every participant is provided with the guidance by the expert and professional. You may ask a question here. What guidance these programs offer to teachers? What to the parents? These programs helps in revealing the new developments to the parents as well as the teachers. Because teachers and parents, they may not be aware about the what are the new developments in the market. Or these programs offer expertise and professional advice to the all stakeholders who are participating in these programs. These programs must be designed to address the needs of the students. See, here is a very important one. What are the requirements of the students? Which type of institution is organizing these programs? So as per the requirement of the students, the programs are to be designed. The teachers and parents must be part of it, which I explained, because they are very important stakeholders as far as the career of the students is concerned. So they must attend these programs and they must be integral part, and they must also learn and impart that knowledge to their prospective students. Vetting of decision making and problem solving ability of the students. Vetting means sharpening. They have to make their own decisions and they have to solve their own problems, challenges by their own. For that reasons, their skilling system has to be vetted so that they can meet the requirement and they can be successful in the civil life or the job market. Then uses of all possible tests and inventories to assess their field of interest and vocational aptitudes. What the experts do is they apply various types of tests, standardized psychological tests, inventories, and computerized tests to the participants so that their original aptitude or their attitude or their personality can be revealed and they can be suggested in which field they are going to fit better. Because when we know the aptitude or personality type of an individual, the similar or matching job profiles can be made known to the students so that they can apply for that. Organization of seminars, symposiums, workshops and conferences related to career options. Because these conferences, seminars, symposiums, workshops, they provide additional information and the type of skill and how to acquire that skill. Overall idea is to improve the skills of the students. The lectures by the experts in order to make the students crack various examinations. Because experts who have gone through these examinations, those passed through these interviews, they know what the practical problems are. So these experts are being called through these programs and they offer their own experiences. I'm not suggesting that we follow the path followed by that individuals. They offer a type of way. This way we can practice, this way we can read, and hence we can crack the various examinations. To offer potential solutions to the individuals and personal problems to students while maintaining confidentiality. In psychology, the confidentiality is the most important point. If student is facing some type of personal problem and want to share with the expert, they can share and ensure that the confidentiality regarding their information is maintained strictly. Maintenance of proper records and documents for analysis, because these documents are very, very important source of information for the coming programs. Everything which is in the records can be made available to the next coming program, and the information can be analyzed properly so that the scientific outcomes can be made, so that what are the shortcomings in the previous programs can be improved in the next and all host of other factors. So these are some characteristics of organization of guidance program. So what are the services offered by the guidance program? There are few services. Information regarding vocational opportunities. What are the vocational opportunities available in the market? These are the services, information provided by the guidance program. Career planning services. How you can plan your career. Vocational preparatory services. You can prepare yourself for the vocational or the professional environment. Counseling services. So very important. This is psychological counseling, where the individual is being suggested, advised, and the important point is student is made aware of his or her strength and made capable to fight and to crack the examination by herself or himself. Then placement services. What are the various placement services are in the market? They are being offered by the guidance programs. Follow-up services. Follow-up means after the student says join some institution, from them the information is being gathered. What is their salary? What is the working environment? What is your productivity? How you feel about that? And is there any shortcomings or some strength? These programs offer such type of services also, because they are in contact with the students who are joined through these programs, and they fetch the information from the students and they make the records. The research services. Research gives the objective output, and that can be generalized across the board. So dear friends, that's all about the organization of the guidance program. These are some references. If you want to cross check or you want to read further, you can go with that. And our next discussion will be what is counseling and why it is required. Thank you for watching this video, and we'll meet you soon. If you have any questions, any queries, you can write in my comment box, or you can email me at womasujit@yahoo.com.